SDTV, my K-expert Lisa Cyphers-Kamen is here to talk about happiness. She is a positive psychology coach, speaker and author, and an internationally renowned happiness expert. How are you?
I am happy to be with you.
Oh, always, always. Isn't it Happiness Day today as well?
Happiness? It is. Today is World Happiness Day. The UN has mandated.
Spreading some happiness.
Spreading joy. And here we are. Love on it. World Happiness Day. Yes.
So you have an organization called Harvesting Happiness.
Yes.
And tell me what you do.
What we do is we help people cultivate greater happiness, but more importantly, well-being and sustainable well-being in their lives.
And you work, you have a segment that works with post-traumatic stress of people who've been in combat, right?
Yes. We have Harvesting Happiness for Heroes, which is a 501c3 nonprofit. Yes. And we do programming for veterans as they transition home from service. And there's so many challenges that these really courageous men and women have been through. But the big challenge is to get back to their civilian lives.
Yeah, well, anyone, I mean, if you deal with homeless people, you've dealt with people who are in poor communities and the veterans, in those kind of situations, it would be a real challenge to be happy.
Well, here's the funny thing about happiness, that happiness can exist alongside adversity.
Wow.
And this is what the science really tells us.
But isn't that what people feel guilty about? They're almost like they shouldn't be feeling happy yet? That if something bad's happened or something bad's going on.
I don't think it's more that they don't see the possibility for joy when they're going through something bad. You know, when we're mired in the muck of when bad things happen, we say, how can I possibly be happy when I've lost my home or when my son is suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder or my child is sick? And the reality of it is, if you don't capture some happiness in the present moment, we don't know what tomorrow will bring.
Yeah.
So part of the beauty of harvesting happiness, or really more importantly, positive psychology, is to really recognize the present moment, to really recognize our strengths and our capacity to be empowered to create a thriving life.
Well, I think that's a really key point, because your situation could be your situation. If you're going to live like that forever, what are you waiting for? You know, 80 years might pass and you might not get to have that experience to have happiness. So you got to have it now.
Well, you have to glean some for yourself now, because people often think that happiness is conditional. Mm-hmm. When I get rich, when I get thin, when I find the perfect mate, when I win the lottery, when.
What, you're telling us it won't make you happy?
It will. I mean, it will add a temporary spike.
Yeah.
That's the other thing. It actually only adds a spike to our happiness.
Like when you go shopping?
Like when you go shopping and you get a fabulous pair of heels. I mean, I personally get a snap of joy from that. And I'm sure you do too.
Yeah.
But it's not sustainable.
No.
So we're talking about teaching skills that really help sustain well-being, you know, such as practicing gratitude, being of service, really defining part of your life as how you can be of use to others.
Yeah.
You know, that instead of being the center of the world, how to be a part of it. You know, really how to use our strengths as human beings to make the world, not just our own lives, a better place.
Now, there's research out there that happiness actually helps us live longer. What's the stats and the studies around this?
You know, I can't give you those exact numbers, but there is research that's coming out saying that happy people tend to live longer because they're not under as much physical stress. They may have stress going on in their lives, but their resiliency factor, their ability to cope with the stress makes it so it does not find it, it doesn't roost in illness as much. But happy people make better partners, better employees, they spend more money, they're better parents. I mean, it goes on and on and on. And we've all experienced this.
Yes. Well, and they're more fun to be around.
Yes. It's infectious. I mean, happiness is really, I say, the positive virus, you know?
Yes. Yes. Well, it's infectious being around you. Thank you so much, as always.
Thank you. I love talking with you.
So if you're out there, find a way to be happy. Glean those small moments of joy. And again through the different weeks that we've been speaking, I keep hearing gratitude coming up. So I think that there's something in that. So I hope that we'll see you soon. I am looking forward to hearing from you. Tweet us, join the conversation on Facebook or YouTube. You can subscribe, and we'll see you soon on Kirsty TV.